What's good, Scrappers? CC Scraps channel. How you guys doing? Again, it is Saturday, and if you just watched my last video, that was that bag of tools I just wanted to share with you guys that my dad gave me. I thought it would be cool. Anyway, it's still Saturday. It's still the same time of the week. It's just about, I don't know, 10 minutes later or something like that, I guess. So anyway, you see this in the background. I went to Harbor Freight. I bought a drill press. I have my old vintage one that is all back, like I said, from Colony Hardware. There's a few mods I'm going to do to it. I need to paint the stand, but it's just been Syracuse, New York weather, upstate New York, if you live around this area, or live where it snows like ridiculously, you'll understand that it's freezing cold, and paint doesn't set when it's cold. Right now it's like about 40, maybe 47, but I tried to paint something last year with this same paint, and it was about this time, and the paint didn't set right, so I'm going to wait till it gets a little warmer, and then I will repaint it, and we'll do the old school retool, like I like to do. But anyway, we're going to unbox this. When I got to Harbor Freight, like, I researched these online, but, you know, obviously, you know, you can't really go up and physically touch things and, you know, see what they do and everything, and I looked at the 10-inch, and I reached the 10-inch and the 12, or, I'm sorry, the 10-inch and the 8-inch, and when I got up close, I really liked the 8-inch. It's got the light. The 10-inch, I really don't need that. You know, I'm not the... This is everything that I need at a decent price. So we're going to sit here and unbox it and see what's going on. You can put accessories on it. The drill press, the little vices and everything. So, you know, we'll upgrade as we need. And we're going to see how this little thing works. I got the 2-year warranty. So if it craps out between now and then, like any big machinery, like my belt sander, it's over there in the background. I don't know if you can see it. Maybe. Hold on. This Bauer right here, I got the 2-year warranty on that. I got the 2-year warranty on my flux core welder. Until I can get a shop where, like, I have actual power, I can run, you know, 230 volt, you know what I mean? Or, you know, so I can really... you know, have that power if I need it. But right now, that little flux core welder is perfect. It's everything I need. And I'm kind of a shitty welder, so it is what it is. So let's get this unboxed. Sit tight, y'all. All right, so we're going to start taking this out of the plastic. I have gloves, but I don't. You can see the... That's good, though. It keeps it from rusting during shipping. It's got to come a long way. So, set that here. This looks like this is a post. Looks like there's some assembly required, which is fine. We got home. Handles. So, good God. That feels weird. It's almost like a, well, when you've ever shopped at Harbor Freight, it's like a, it's kind of got like a baby oil texture, or maybe like a, like almost like a thinner vegetable oil kind of like texture to it, so to speak, I guess, if that's what I can think of. I'll cut that off before I hurt it. It's a nice light. I mean it's pretty well built. Like, I'm not kidding you. Like, I mean, that's plastic, obviously, but I mean, it's solid. Like, that's pretty decent metal. It's heavy. Like, this is probably maybe 2 pounds. This is maybe 3 pounds. I mean, it's got some girth to it, so to speak. Excuse me. Whew. It is starting to warm up. Maybe I could paint a little later, but I want to share that with you guys. You know, y'all can use these stator motors. Or the... Yeah, the stator. For, yeah, that's redneckery, y'all. Or actually, well, long time ago I spent... We had a camp up in Sandy Pond, New York, and I'm just trying to check everything out to see how it's going to fit together before I start bolting stuff down. Because I'm not going to go by the directions, because the directions are, I don't know, man. I can kind of figure it out. I've watched enough of the setups and the reviews and things. We're going to bolt this to the post and go from there. Sit tight. All right, so I had to pause the camera for a second. I'm looking at this like there's the washers on here compared to the bolt diameter. To me, aren't... I feel like the washer should be bigger. And you see what I mean? Like, I just think it should be a bigger... Well, here, wait. I feel like it should be a bigger... Oops, I keep hitting the camera. Sorry, folks. I feel like it should be a bigger diameter for that. Can you see that? I'm sorry. I'm trying to, like... See what I mean? How it's not... I feel like it should be wider on the foot of this base. So I'm going to go with what they have. And then I'm going to deal with it if I have to. I have washers that will fit this. And I will use them if I have to. I just think they're too small. I don't know. So we'll see what happens. And the gloves that I have to use are slippery. I don't have... Oh, wait a minute. What do I do? Where are they? You ever lose shit in your workshop, scrappers, tool guys, anybody? Because I have so much... Woo-wee, I needed the other side of this garage. Anyway. Or a basement. That's the next thing I want. It's a nice, decent cement floor basement that's warm, that has freaking lighting, and oh, I can't wait. Hopefully soon that'll happen. What was I doing? Dang, I just slipped into neutral, folks. Oh, well, since I'm in neutral, let's talk about what happened. My wife today, Mrs. CC Scraps, actually gave me some scrap. These cake pan molds that I bought her, and then they were just not sufficient for her baking talents. And they crapped out on her, so she got ticked off. And I'm probably going to get her some other ones, because that's what she likes to do, and she's pretty damn good at it. I'll post a picture in one of my videos of her... Actually, in this video, I'll post a picture of the cake she made my mom for her 50th birthday. It's just... It's next level. So, I'm going to pause the camera and figure out what I was trying to do. It was gloves. All right, we're back and dry, folks. Let's go, right? First to sixth. If you're on a motorcycle. You ever do that? If you guys, I don't know if you guys out there watch my videos, rode a motorcycle before. Jimmy C. Oh, and by the way, in my last video, thank you for all the help, Scout Crafter. I was looking, see, the thing is I have two phones, and one's my YouTube phone and one's my regular phone. So I was going through the comments on my other YouTube, my Christopher Cicerelli channel. Well, it's not even a channel, it's just a YouTube. I don't have any content on it. It's just there, and it helps me monitor my other channel when I'm down in the shop, which I don't have internet out here, and my YouTube phone, which is just what we're on right now, is it's not connected so to the internet. It's not on. It's just used as a camera, more or less. So I'm going to just tighten these down, just a quick crescent wrench. Do I have enough to do this bit? Hold on a minute. Let's make life easy. We got going. Oh, wait a minute. Come on. Come on, Pittsburgh. You know what? You rotten bastard. See, this is another reason why Like, all right, Harbor Freight, they sell, I bought these at Harbor Freight, and I need one size bigger. Like, they don't sell that size. That's crazy. Harbor Freight, come on, man. That should be compatible with Pittsburgh and the stuff that you guys sell. I'm just saying. Just saying. Then again, your prices for... It's... I could poke you like this, Harbor Freight. Anyway, so back to... I guess I could go get a socket, but I don't really feel like digging them out. So, let's see what we got here. Let's go with the adjustables. Or not the adjustables, but the open ends. Let's see what we got. This is really going to be a long setup video. I'm going to pause the camera. This is working. This is a 9/16, which is surprisingly weird. But okay, yeah, whatever. Sit tight. All right, so I got it tightened up pretty good. I mean, it's... Ooh, there's some sharp edges on here. I got to file off underneath. If you get one of these, be careful underneath. This is pretty solid. Maybe this washers will be all right. It bolted down pretty good. So I'm going to set the press here on top. Can you guys see that? I'm going to lift you. Hello, y'all. All right. So... we'll center it. Yeah, this will work, man. It's got some set screws. Looks like it is a hex wrench that they give you, which is cool. So I'm going to center this. Let me get my engineering square. Just going to see if it's... I'm going to make sure that... I just want a reference point of it being straight on, like straight, you know what I mean, this way. I think that's alright. It seems pretty solid. I mean, you can bolt it down. It's got bolts, which eventually I may do. I just got a home for it now. I was cleaning off over here. Remember all the stuff that used to be there if you all watch my videos? Whoops. It's going to live here for now. So this grinder is going to go this way. And I don't need to keep it plugged in because I have one of these things hanging up, 30 foot. You know, my garage isn't 30 feet long. It's a one-car garage. Like, you can fit a car in here. Like a medium car, not even a big car. Like if y'all are rolling like one of them ghetto Bentleys, like a 300M, maybe. I highly doubt it though. But I do with what I could do. Alright, so check it out. I'm going to just tighten this down a little. It's two set screws. We're on center. Where'd my square go? Oh, I'm having a... Oh, here we go. Wow, come on. Get with it, CC Scratch. You're filming, bud. There we go. Alright, so we're going to just tighten these down a little bit. A couple of set screws. So, it just keeps this thing tight. So... there, a little crank on it, tighten it down a little bit. I don't want it too tight, but I don't want it to move either. I don't know how, I don't want to drive these screws into this thing either and dent it. So that seems pretty tight. I don't know if it's weak or not, so, but it looks pretty, like, it's built, like, once it's bolted down, like, this thing's not going to go nowhere. I don't know where this goes, so I'm going to have to read the directions, unfortunately. So apparently I'm a dumbass, and this has to come off again. Because I didn't put the tray on first, see? I knew that. I watched the video, too. I even watched it. So, again, like I say, thank you for all your comments on my last video of all those tools. You know, like I said, I slipped into neutral. Jimmy C. knew what the PIA was. Scout Crafter, thank you. And it's weird because this thing's right here. And it's I hung it up because it kind of looks cool. But it's got a... I mean, the only thing holding the to capture the nut, like when you get it to the tightness, is it's like a it almost looks like an Allen key, like a an Allen key bolt. Like it's just not, I don't know. I don't think it's really strong. I don't know, but it looks cool. Might even go to the scrapyard. I don't know yet. We'll see. It's a tool. So I don't know. Maybe it'll have its place. We'll see. We'll see. Alright, let me fix this. I remedied the problem. I got the tray on. I'm going to turn this towards you guys. There we go. So, I'm going to install now the handles for the press itself. Just the standard thread. I like this thing. I think me and this drill press are going to get along just fine. I found out where that thing went. It went right there for the belt adjustment. So, that's weird. Alright. Then we'll go here. These are my little presses. My little presses, my little handle. Okay, nice and snug. Now, in order to install the chuck, they want you to take your tray, lift it up a little, use a block of wood. Well, I don't have a block of wood, so what I'm going to use is I got these pieces of metal. Like, I've been saving a lot of weird-looking metal, like scrap metal, for when I'm going to start my metal. I don't know. We'll get into that later, but anyway. That's another video. But anyway, just I like to have random things of metal laying around. So you take the chuck. They said to open the jaws all the way, which was what I did with the provided with the provided chuck key, which stinks. They don't have a place to hang it. Harbor Freight, come on, that wouldn't have cost much more to do. You know, somewhere. I mean, maybe here. Can you put magnet? Like, if I put a magnet up here, is that going to mess with the motor? I don't know. That's why I don't like really doing that. I don't know if it will or not, but... And you know what? I guess I could magnetic it down here somewhere. Yeah, I guess I could put it to here. Because I don't really think that tray is ever going to be really that low. If it is, I can always move it. See, all right, problem solved. Sorry, Harbor Freight. But anyway. So, I'm going to go like this here. That there. Maybe stack the metal. Actually, I'm gonna do this. Grab your level ones. Grab your love, partner. And they want you to just push this down and press it on. Supposed to go up here. To the left, to the left now. To the right, to the right. Now, yeah, let me read a little more on the directions. Well, we got it all set up. Here's the light. Works pretty nice. Here, let me put you go this way. So here's the light. You hear it run. I got it on the highest speed, so it's going to be loud. It's loud, but it's on the highest speed, so it's supposed to be spinning at 3,070 RPM. But, you see for my wire brush, you know, if I want to drill holes in metal, I'll slow it down. You can slow it down all the way to 760. It goes 760, 1150, 1630, 2180, and 3070 for RPM. And there we go here. All right. So, We're all set up on the Harbor Freight Central Machinery 5-speed drill press. This is a 8-inch drill press. I'm pretty happy with it. Chuck key. Set screw. I don't really like the way they make you press the chuck on. I think they should have did that at the factory. But hey, whatever. It is what it is. It works. It's going to live here. So, all right. Thanks for hanging out. This is a long video. If it was boring, I apologize. I try to make it fun and whatever. But anyway, have a great weekend. CC Scraps, y'all. Peace. We're about to order some Chinese food. Yeah, buddy. General Tso. Peace, y'all.